We're sharing with the homeless that they're God's treasure. And as we share that with them, we want you to know that you are also. We live in a society that if you don't have money, they make you feel like you're junk. We want the homeless to know, and each and every one of you, that you are someone special in the kingdom of God. So please join us, pray for us as we gather together here, the New Life Evangelistic Center team, helping the hurting, the homeless, reaching out through the love of God. Morning. You are God's treasure.
That's right.
We want everybody to know that. Somebody special, uniquely and wonderfully made in the image of God.
That's right.
And that we have special gifts for you here today. A transportation assistance, food, hygiene kits, Bibles. So we just want each and every one of you to know that you're special in the kingdom of God. Does anybody here need a Bible? Need a Bible? You have a Bible. Let's read the Bible. It's the God's word. You need a Bible?
Man, it's written on the tablet.
All right.
Oh, I got one.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Well, what's your favorite verse in it?
I can do all things.
Oh, that's good, isn't it?
Philippians 4:19.
Yes. And my God shall supply all your needs for his riches and grace.
Glory in Christ Jesus.
Amen. So we stand on those promises. I like to write them all out, stick it in that verse and cover it. The devil tries to make me worry, say, hey, it's covered by the word of God.
And also Isaiah 54:17, no weapon formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue that rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn.
Oh, yeah,
but Isaiah, this is the heritage of the saints.
Glory be to God. Isaiah 26:3, thou keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed upon thee.
Mm.
Because he trusts in thee. So we need that peace too.
That's right.
And right.
That's right.
We can trust God regardless. The devil can try to throw this at us, that at us, but Jesus is Lord, isn't he?
That's right.
That's what gives you the strength to keep going?
That's right. The word.
Amen.
It's a lamp unto my feet.
Wow. And if the saints weren't on this earth, you think, to get raptured to heaven? Well, pure hell would break out, wouldn't it?
Mm-hmm.
The salt in the city.
Yeah.
Amen. So realize how critical the word of God is at this particular hour. And I thank God for those of you that are helping us to be able to live it out.
That's right.
To let our light shine. Jesus said, let your light so shine before men and women, they may see your good works and glorify our Father who's in heaven. All righty, you guys ready to start here?
Yes, we are.
Okay. We thank God, and we want to ask, are you ready to start? Are you ready to help at this time that we can reach out through the love of Christ and just share? If you'd like one of these studies, you're God's treasure, give us a call, 314-421-3020. That's 314-421-3020. Praise God. And as you can see, the homeless are lining up here. Also, we're having to put the clothes out here. Again, I ask you to continue to pray. Pray for the opening of the New Life Evangelistic Center at 1411 Locust, right down the street, where they could come in any day and be able to pick right from the clothes, right from the free store. So pray that that church will reopen down there. We've seen the great discrimination against the poor and the homeless. People, rich folks moving in the neighborhood, don't want poor people, don't want the church. So again, where's the outcry from the body of Christ? Well, we know that God cares. So I get down on my knees and pray about that. I'm asking you to join me in doing that as we reach out through the love of Christ. Again, get into God's word. And as you do that, you're going to see over and over Jesus identifying with the hurting and the homeless. He said, foxes have holes, birds have nests, but he, the man, Son of Man, had nowhere to lay his head. He tells us also in Matthew 25, when I was hungry, did you feed me? Naked, did you clothe me? Sick or in prison, visit me? As oft you've done to the least, he said, even so you've done it to me. So let's let our light so shine. Let's let the light and love of Christ flow in us and through us. Let's watch him do exceedingly beyond what we can even ask or think. I praise God. We've got Joe over here that says, no Jesus, no peace. Chris Aaron's joining us, and we're just out here sharing the word of the Lord with people.
Absolutely.
Letting everybody know that they are not junk, but they're God's treasure for such a time like this, aren't they?
Yeah, we are created in the image of God. They deserve respect and dignity just for that fact alone. Often, we forget about them, or they're treated as subclass citizens, and that's not right at all. In a Christian faith, we've got to respect our brothers and sisters.
Well, Jesus came. He broke through those class barriers, and he just let his light shine, and then he sends us forth as his ambassadors.
Right.
To let our light so shine before men and women, they may see our good works and glorify our Father who's in heaven. All glory goes to God.
Right.
As we let his light and love just shine in us and work through us. And we want to encourage you to join us at New Life Evangelistic Center. You can let us know. You can email us. You can find out more by going to NLECSTL.org. You can call us at 314-421-3020 because we welcome volunteers, don't we?
Absolutely. We could not do this work alone, and So if you are able to give some of your time to come and help serve with us, it's so important to what we do.
And again, there are a lot of homeless that need your help. These are just a few lining up right here, right now. Need any help? And I thank God for those of you that are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center, sending your gifts to P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166. You can give online at NLECSTL.org and just let Christ's light and love flow in you and through you. I thank God for those of you are sharing and those of you that are praying that the Church of New Life Evangelistic Center can reopen at 1411 Locust, where not only have they closed through the free store, but be able to take showers, be able to get their mail somewhere, be able to store their belongings, be able to have a place just to lay their head and rest. Please pray for a miracle, because God's in the miracle-working business. And we got a lot more in store for you. I just want you to continue to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center at this time.
I didn't catch your name.
De Niro.
De Niro. Well, it was very good to meet you. How important is bus passes to you?
It means I can get around. I can always make my meetings. I can go to court if I need to. Yeah. I don't have to call in a lot of excuses. I can make my counseling meetings.
So
it's really
so
the lifeblood of me getting off the streets.
Yeah. Right. Absolutely. So he's going to get you some bus passes. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
How are you doing today? Good. So what's one of the hardest things about living on the streets in St. Louis?
Well, it's hard. You know, I just got a prison. You know what I'm saying? Last night I slept at a bus stop. You know what I'm saying? Be gunshots and everything else. The tickets helped me a lot to go job hunting and everything else, try to find a job, you know, so.
Yeah, you got out of prison, but it's really hard to find jobs or housing when you get out of prison.
Yeah,
right?
With no transportation, you know.
Yeah, well, not only that, a lot of doors are closed when you get out of prison.
Yeah, it is.
There aren't very many people who are willing to help people.
Mm-hmm.
And you did your time.
Mm-hmm.
You did all of that, so you should be able to get into a place and find jobs easily.
Right,
but
right. There
are extra barriers in front of you.
Yes, it is. And it's hard out here in these streets, you know what I'm saying? I mean, the homeless don't have a place to use the bathroom or nothing, and everything else, you know. So, you know, I mean, y'all pretty much know what go on around here, you know, out on the street. It's real hard. Larry Rice, he helps you out in any way he can, so.
We're trying to get 1411 open as a day shelter where you can use a bathroom, you can get showers, you can do your laundry, all of those really important things, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so just pray that we continue to get that open.
I will be praying.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for talking to me today. How are you doing today?
All right.
You're doing all right. It was chilly last night, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Were you able to were you staying on the streets?
Yeah, I am.
Oh, yeah.
By the post office. Real cold.
It's really cold.
Yeah.
A lot of people think it's summer now, but that weather fluctuation, it's still going up and down, up and down. And it's so hard when it's raining or anything like that to get in to a place where it's safe, right?
Yeah.
We're trying to open up 1411 Locust as a day shelter where people can really get in, get warm, get cool in the heat of summer, because that's coming, right?
Yeah.
And it's going to get really hot.
Yeah, I can tell by the weather now.
Yeah. And so we just pray. How do you use bus passes every single day?
I usually walk.
Yeah.
You know.
And you've got a cane.
It takes a little time. Yeah.
It's hard to walk and move around, isn't it?
Yeah. I had an accident on the job, so I got hurt. And that got me in this position here. Can't find houses. 27 weeks. 18 weeks and 27 months.
Wow.
So that's, you might as well say, almost 2 years before you even get up.
Yeah.
Low income, because so many people shelter, so many people are disabled, you know, and they first.
Well, we're going to help you out with some bus passes today. I know that, like you said, it's so important. It's critical.
Right.
So that you don't have to walk every single place that you go.
Right.
All right, Ray will help you. Thank you so much.
Okay.
How are you doing, Fred? How are you doing?
I'm all right. I'm doing better, man.
You're doing better. What's better today than last week?
I'm trying to get to a place.
You're trying to get a place?
Yeah, they told me I had to go to the housing authority and get a Section 8.
Okay, so you're trying to get into a place,
And bus passes help you get to those meetings. They help you get to the place itself, right? You need these bus passes just to do the daily business that you've got to do.
That's
get
right.
done, right?
Yeah.
You got a cane. Oh, your cane's better. Did you get a new cane?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah, dude.
Praise the Lord. It's a little better for you to lean on, and you're getting around better, right?
Yes.
Okay. Mm. Amen.
I had a slight stroke last week. They told me about what you call that? You eat a lot of fruit, oranges, and my potassium was too high. But I'm trying to work on it. They told me they didn't want me to leave out the hospital, but I had something to do. So I left. She said, well, if you feel that you need to go back, go back to your primary doctor and tell her to check your what's it called?
Cortisol levels.
Yeah, make sure it's all right.
Yeah. So is it hard to experience a stroke, even if it's a small, minor one, on the streets? Is that difficult?
Oh, yeah.
It's scary. I mean,
you could pass out in one of these parks or on a bus or something like that. Man, this is crazy.
Yeah.
But like I said, the Lord making the way so long.
Yeah.
That's what I can
put
do.
One foot in front of the other. These bus passes help you do that,
yes,
right?
Sir. Yes,
all
sir.
Right. Well, thank you, Fred, for talking with us. We appreciate you.
Thank you.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing a lot.
You're doing?
I'm walking, I got my cane.
Yeah.
I came back. I used to, I got robbed and I was, couldn't eat or none of that. And so I'm going to plug up to keep me alive.
So now, God has kept you safe and He's walked with you through all of this, right?
All right, man, safe.
Yeah. What do bus passes do for you every single day?
Help me get to more clinics and doctors and see who I'm supposed to see and see my family.
Yeah. Are there a lot of people that you're supposed to see?
Yes, my daughter. I got two daughters. One of them is 3 years old on Christmas. One will be 19 this year. And then I got my nieces and nephews.
Yeah.
So I spend my life on taking care of them.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, Reverend Ray is going to help you get some bus passes. I know that they're really, really important.
That's my buddy, dog.
Yeah, all right. Well, he'll help you out, okay?
Thank you.
All right. What's your name?
My name's Franklin Spriggs.
Okay. And I see you got a cross on. Do you know that you are a child of God?
Yeah.
Born,
what up?
Adopted by Jesus Christ. Okay. Amen.
Yeah.
So it's so
good.
You feel good?
Yeah.
Okay. Were you able to get some clothes, you're trying to get some bus passes right
now?
Yeah, What do bus passes do for you?
Man, help me get around. Catch the bus. They can't get on nothing with them.
How many miles do you think you walk every single day?
Man, it's about 20.
God don't like us.
Yeah.
I'm tired of walking.
Yeah.
You're tired of walking.
Tired of machines.
Yeah. You're trying to get on a bus to get to where you need to go.
Yeah, where I gotta go.
Okay.
Larry Rice, he is the greatest.
Yeah. Have you been receiving services from Larry Rice for a long time?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is at 1411 Locust.
Okay, yeah. So we're trying to get that back open at the day shelter.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I'll be there.
All right. Well, it's good to see you today. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing today?
All right.
Okay, did you stay out on the streets last night?
Not of course.
Okay.
I had a spot to go last.
Good, good. It's getting cold, isn't it?
Yeah. Should have been warm, but it's getting cold.
Yeah, it's already May, but it dropped down to 45 degrees last night.
That's cold.
And it's cold. It's hard to move around. How long have you been experiencing homelessness?
Oh, well, about a year.
A year?
Yeah.
What's one of the biggest struggles that you face?
Transportation.
Are you looking for jobs, trying to get to your meetings or your caseworkers?
Doctors.
Yeah, it's really, really important to get those bus passes.
Yes, it is.
Well, thank you so much for talking with us.
Thank you,
really,
sir.
Really appreciate it. There are so many people that we were able to help only because you are allowing Christ's light and love to flow through you. Please partner alongside us. Support the work of New Life because there are so many people out here who need transportation, who need help getting to where they need to go. St. Louis is a very spread out city, and you have to have bus passes just to get around and break the cycle of homelessness. It's a very big barrier.
Chris, Aaron, we're here with Terry at this time. Hi, Terry.
Hello, how are you?
I saw you on the street Sunday, I believe, right?
Yes, sir.
And you said you were in a pretty desperate situation at that time.
Yes, still am.
You still are?
Yes.
what you need some help, do you?
Yes, I do.
I think some of the things that you need, a lot of people don't take into consideration, particularly men, how hard it is being a homeless woman out on the street, right?
Very true.
Yeah. She was saying I didn't even have a pad at that time. Right. Things were really, really rough. You were telling me how... Tell Chris Aaron here what you told me about how somebody stole your stimulus check.
Yeah, I was sleeping and my stuff was beside me and I wake up and gone.
Yeah, it was all gone. That happens quite a bit.
Right.
How many times has somebody stolen from you?
I've been wanting them very much.
Really? But you continue to keep trusting God, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
Day by day.
I cried last night.
Did you really?
I apologize, yeah.
Why did you cry?
Mm-hmm.
Why did you cry?
Just being home.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What does it mean to you to be able to come here and get help like this?
It'll mean a lot.
Does it really?
Mm-hmm.
You look forward to it?
Yes, sir.
Folks, you give the homeless something to look forward to as you pray and support the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. I ask you to let the light and love of Christ shine in you and through you at this particular time. Where did you sleep last night?
On the ground right over here. It just got a little chilly.
You did? You were laying, just laying on the ground?
Yes.
Wow.
You got to get my stuff together. They didn't give me my check. And everything, because they don't know, like, I'm not in jail. I got to have a company send it to the Social Security office so they know that I'm not incarcerated.
Had a hard life.
Yes.
Have you ever just given it all to Jesus?
Huh?
You ever just given it all to the Lord?
Hi, everybody.
How are you?
I'm good.
That's wonderful. So you cooked this up to help make it for
yes.
the people?
Yes.
How are you today? Right,
you
Trey,
want
to talk to me a minute here while I talk to Chris?
Bye, Audrey.
Bye.
Good to see you. Well, God bless you. Hey, we got a new mask over there for you, okay?
Some juice right there.
Okay?
I got coffee.
As you can see, a lot of activity out here there, Chris.
Yes, yeah, we got a lot of people here today. We're able to serve them and get them what they need most. So.
And prayerfully, we'll be able to get inside 1411 Locust.
Absolutely. We need a day shelter in St. Louis. There's no reason why so many people have to be outside exposed to the heat and to the cold and to the rain. So we need to get people off the streets in the day.
Yeah, you brought that up right, brother. Where do you shower at?
Yeah,
clothes, showers. Where can they shower at? Where are the clothes at?
Internet services.
Yep. Yes.
A place to lock up safe documents. You know, she was saying that all her stuff was stolen. Well, if we had a day shelter, we'd be able to have lockers for men and women, and they could put that in a safe place.
And like you mentioned, the computer where they can look for jobs. We have all that in Springfield for our we have the largest daytime facility, southwestern Missouri, northwestern Arkansas. All those people would be on the street like they are in St. Louis if it wasn't for the fact that building was open.
Can you support if somebody needs
a... Well, thank you very much. God bless you, sister. She makes up dinners and bring them out to the people here. Good morning. How are you today? All right. Good day. God bless you.
I got a bet that I missed with you this morning. I got a bet for them.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, Rose jumped off that bridge.
Oh, no. So she's a homeless woman that just got...
The one tried to cut you. She jumped off the bridge.
Well, I prayed for her. I prayed for
her. I did too, but Larry,
she had so many, many problems, mm-hmm. so many different issues, okay? Mm-hmm. So we just, wow. So
yeah, she jumped off the bridge.
Wow. So it's tough. And I
got to give me some clothes, Larry.
You help yourself. Folks, as you can see, a lot of them depend on this. Just coming out like this, and she mentioned a homeless woman. Women are dying out here.
We have a lot of people. I mean, COVID-19 has added a lot of stress to people who are in homes, but it's made it even worse for people who don't have homes. It's made a lot harder for them to access resources that they need. And if it wasn't for New Life kind of continuing to do this every single day or every single week, we wouldn't be able to get what they need into their hands. And so it can drive somebody to make desperate.
Well, and I want to clarify, too, that lady, she didn't try to cut me. She was just loud one day. She came just so loud and boisterous. And I'm quietly just binding up the spirits that are inside. They're just coming out and really cared for her. Saw her a few days later out on the streets, and we helped her again. I mean, there's so much hurt, so much pain out there. And, wow, I just grieve to hear concerning Rose and
they see this happening to their other ladies that are out here. That's why we have our safe houses. Please pray for us. We want to open in the near future another safe house. And I'm asking you to just continue to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And just let Christ's love flow through you. We do need your help. We can't do it without your tax-deductible gifts. New Life receives no city, state, or federal dollars. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166. And let's just let the light and love of Christ shine in us and through us, right?
Absolutely. We as Christians have every responsibility and duty to obey the words of Christ. And to obey the words of Christ means to act, to serve, to love the your neighbor as yourself. You can't love your neighbor as yourself just sitting on your couch watching TV. You got to get up and actually do something. Partner with us. Support the work of New Life. We are striving to help as many people as we can. The need is so great right now. We really, really need your help right now.
Right. Donations have a tendency to go down during the summertime. We need you to just believe God with us for a miracle, because in addition to the needs we're describing to you here in the United States, we're also trying to help in India. Our team in India, Papara Yelachuri, they have like so many pastors over there. And I want y'all to remember Papara. I believe he's viewing at this time. Papara, we are praying for you over there. I just sent a letter out. I want you to pray for that to 2,000 donors. He described to me, Chris, and he's going to be getting to me in a few days, the description from four, and there's every day there's more coming in, little children who've lost their parents as a result of this COVID. And so we have our orphanage there. We desperately need oxygen and for the people there. You need some ventilators that are there. We're asking all of you to continue to pray. I praise God for our dear brother Ed in California, who just donated $20,000. I think that they got that off yesterday, or be getting it off today. And then we were able to gather together some 3,000 from here, but we need to get more from this end. And we're asking people to pray for that. Same time, we're facing some financial needs here at New Life, but we can't forget those brothers and sisters. You were with me the last time we were in India, weren't you?
Yeah, this morning on the news, they said that yesterday, India hit an all-time global high for the most cases in any country. Over 415,000 cases in one single day. And so it's not just our hospital that's in dire straits. All over the country, they are making incredibly hard decisions about who lives and who dies in India.
And Papa Ross sent us from the hospital that we helped the foundation, Hope Hospital, the 75-year-old man that came. He finally got a bed. His daughter and him found a bed. And this young man, 40, in his 40s, and his wife was there, and the kids, and they were told they didn't have a bed. Children start crying. The man went to the desk and said, "Look, you can have my bed. I've had a full life." And he signed his bed over to that man. And then the 75-year-old died 3 days later. These are the kind of things that you're hearing, seeing. India prayed for us when the United States was going through this. During the past year, India was on their knees praying for us. Now it's our time to pray for India. Our brothers and sisters in India, I can think of so many occurrences during all these years since 1988 that they got down and prayed for us.
You know, we're trying to save physical lives, but also Papa Rao has just said that this has been the best ability for him to witness to, to the families of people who were impacted by COVID-19. So they've had a lot of lives saved spiritually as well. And so, it's that reminder that death is not the end. That COVID-19, all it can do is take away the life, but we are giving life. Jesus Christ gives us life eternally, and so we're able to use this opportunity to witness to the families, the children, the people who are impacted by this horrible, horrible virus. And so, in some ways, it's a blessing. You know, Papa Rao was saying that 12 souls were saved in a single day, and just over and over.
And the man
over
that
again,
I described earlier, had just given his life to Christ, and now that I found Jesus, that the thing is, though, is that he's really witnessing in the middle of it all. That's been my burden for all that we've encountered in the United States.
Right.
Last night, my wife Deborah and I had a great time. We gathered for 2 hours and listened to the National Day of Prayer. And we prayed together with the people. And what I appreciate about that was that over that prayer group, people were repenting. They're saying, "We need to repent. We need to just get right with God." And that's what needs to come out of this in our country, as well as around the world, as it encounters, that we call out to God. We repent as a people. We surrender our lives to Him.
It's so easy to get caught up in our materialism that we let our light so shine. And so just go to God and join us. Let's pray. Let's believe God. Let's be obedient to God at this hour, right?
Absolutely. I read Psalm 51 today, which is where David is rendering his heart before God after his sin with Bathsheba. And that he says, create in me a clean heart, O God. Renew a right spirit within me. We've got to literally break our hearts for the sins that we know that we've committed or the ones that we don't know that we've committed, and lift them up to God, reorder our hearts, put Him first above all else, all our worries, all our concerns, all our blessings, everything. Put Him first, recognize His sovereignty in our lives, and He will forgive us.
So we want to do that. We're out here with the homeless at this time. They're looking for their clothes. They're shopping out here. There are many, many people facing needs at this time. I'm asking you to continue to keep the building at 1411 Locust in your prayers so we can get it open. They got them up there. No, I think we just had the white ones today. I'll have to get those next week. Looks like you're finding some clothes.
Sure did.
Praise the Lord. Sure did.
And I got my plate.
You did?
Yep. I move in Monday.
Praise God.
Yeah, I've been down here on Hogan. I'm going to invite you in the bathroom.
Okay. Now, this is where you do your shopping each week?
Sure do every week.
All right. Well, thank God.
I shop at Mason. Only it's called Larry Wright.
Oh, yeah, right.
I'm shopping.
A lot better for our prices, too, right?
I ain't got no prices.
Yeah, right. Everything's free.
Because you got.
Yeah, it's all Jesus gives it, and we share it.
Sure do.
God bless you.
Yep, yep. And I got a bet, too. In case they miss, which I'm going
to
bow.
Oh, well, you know, we're going to take it to God in prayer, okay?
Yeah, sometimes God can't handle it right here.
He can handle it. If He can't handle it, I'm ready to go.
Okay?
He can take care of it. We can do all things through Christ.
I love you.
God bless you.
Yeah, I move in Monday, and I want you to come and bless my place.
Hallelujah. So you got your own place now.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
See, brothers and sisters, keep on praying.
Monday. I got your number. I'm going to call you. I want you and the pastor to come and bless my house.
All right. Lord
bless. It's called Larry Wright's Kitchen.
Well, God bless you. All right. How are you doing?
I came to see about the ID.
I got your kids.
Oh, sure. Pastor Ray, he's right over there with them, okay?
Oh, okay.
Talk to him about that, and I got to give him some checks to help you get your ID. Now, let's talk a minute. Why is an ID so important?
Can't get nowhere without an ID.
Yeah.
I lost mine.
So we try to help you here get your IDs, don't we?
Mm-hmm. You go on Grand and Lindo.
Let's go over here and talk to her.
Yeah. I'm going
to
go on Grand and Lindo. Get it free. I got my ID yesterday in the mail.
All right.
They give you, they give me the birth certificate. I go on Tuesday at 9.
All right. Got that. Okay. Ray. Yeah, you're looking. Some people are asking about their ideas. She's just saying that they can go to Grand and Lindo, but you take it right out to the streets, don't you?
Right.
The IDs.
I got my ID
We take the checks.
Tell them about the IDs. I've got some that I'm going to go get for you while you do that. Okay.
Yeah. We help them with the check so that they can pay for the ID. They actually have to get the ID here at City Hall or at one of the other facilities that issues the state IDs. But we provide them with a check. In most cases, they also need to obtain their birth certificate, which also, that's $15 for the birth certificate here in Missouri, $18 for the state ID. So right away, it's $33. If they lose their ID and if they don't lose their birth certificate too, then they have to go through the same process all over again.
Yeah, and how often does that happen, Ray? Because it seems to happen. Quite
just
quickly.
This past week, I talked to somebody. They said, well, somebody stole their wallet. Their wallet had the ID. Wallet had their birth certificate. So they had to go through the process again. I know it can be very frustrating for somebody that's homeless. And
some checks so you can get that they can get some more IDs.
Right.
And then,
appreciate that, yeah.
And then she was telling about another group that you can tell them about, the one on, I guess, Grand Lindo.
Right, yeah, St. Francis.
Praise God, they're doing that. So we're all working together here for the glory of God.